Banner Elk is a small mountain town probably known best for its association with North Carolina skiing. But in the fall, Banner Elk puts on one of the most unique festivals you'll find across our state. This festival has everything you'd expect to find in a fall festival. There's fair food and tent after tent of crafts and vendors. Like most mountain festivals, there's a healthy dose of music to enjoy over the weekend. And you can even find a genuine high country storyteller to while away the hours. But make no mistake about it, the Woolly Worm Festival in Banner Elk got its name because the Woolly Worm gets center stage for a full weekend in October. Now, this isn't just 2 days of celebrating the Woolly Worm, it's 2 days of racing Woolly Worms up a string. And like most races in this state, it brings out a lot of people.
We had 60 people at our first festival, and now we have over 20,000 in the 2 days. Now, that's not real big if you live in Raleigh with some of the stuff going on there, but when you're in a one-stoplight, small tourist town, and you bring 20,000 people and crowd them into a small field like this, that's a lot of people.
Ready, march, set, go! All right, they're off and racing. We've got...
Now, people don't just come out for the thrill of the race. There are cash prizes up to $1,000 if your worm is the grand prize winner. And the grand prize winning worm is pretty important at this festival because its unique coloring is supposed to predict the upcoming winter weather.
Every season has 13 weeks on your calendar. I didn't know that in school, but I've learned it since. And a woolly worm has 13 of these body segments. So you start at his head is the first week and his tail is the last week of winter. And you judge by the color of that segment. The darker black it is means there's going to be natural snow that week. The more rich chocolate, deep brown means that it's going to be more severe cold. And that means you're going to be 25, 20, 10 in that dreaded 0 degree weather and below that we get up here sometime. And then if it's a light brown, that means normal winter weather for the mountains. At night it's going to freeze, more than likely. They'll be able to make snow on the mountains. But then in the daytime it gets fairly comfortable. A little colder than it is today, but fairly comfortable.
So if you're coming out to the Woolly Worm Fest and you want a race, you need to find a worm. And usually the best place is on a quiet back road this time of year.
So go on a side road when the sun's shining and they're crawling across that asphalt. But when I jump out, they see this hat and they say, oh God, that's that woolly worm guy, he's crazy anyway. And they put up with me and I collect some worms.
So if you can't get out and pick your own worm, you can buy some racing worms at the festival.
Well, you guys were looking at your worms. Anything jump out at you while you picked these particular worms?
Yeah.
We have a bet.
We have a bet. This, I heard the slow one, and I got to be the fast one.
This one runs like crazy. Mine hardly moves. This is not fair.
And once you have your worm, you have to come up with a name.
This is Tennessee Flash, because she's a big Alabama fan. And she lost $5 to me on the game yesterday. So she's trying to get it back. She won't.
This is Woolly Wonder.
Woolly Wonder.
Woolly Wonder.
All right, we'll check out your guys' progress. Thanks.
After you've named and registered your worm, it's time to sit back and wait for your heat and begin to come up with a strategy.
He's eager to race, and this is the semifinal coming up, so we think we're going to win.
Is there any strategy when you're up there with Scotty?
Well, we let him have a nap after his first race, and now he's getting warmed up again.
Once the race starts, you cannot touch the string or the worm. And you may have noticed two main strategies to hurry your worm along. Look here as we observe the clapping beneath the worm method and the blowing underneath the worm method. There is no evidence that one is really better than the other. After getting to observe a few races, it was my turn. My worm started out strong at the beginning of the race, but before long I noticed that the other worms just seemed to be outpacing him.
Stop!
And just like that, my dreams of worm glory were over.
What happened to your worm?
I don't know, he must have reached his goal. Stop.
He's hanging on for all his worth.
No worries, there's always next year, plenty of racing left to watch, beautiful weather to enjoy, and a fair going on all around you. And you always can start planning for next year. I think the first thing I'll do is pump the 2-time winner Michael and his worm Hurricane about where to find the fastest worms. For North Carolina Weekend, this is John Bollenbacher.